first fears tonight that the state's power supplies could be under threat after the Morwell River broke its banks, sending floodwaters rushing into the Yallourn open-cut mine.
What was supposed to be a trickle turned into a torrent, a diverted section of the Morwell River bursting its banks, sending water gushing through a tunnel. In ruins, the conveyor system that transports coal to the power station, and water filling the open-cut mine that provides more than 20% of the state's power.
Meanwhile, engineers are being confronted with the massively challenging and expensive task of working out a way of plugging the banks of the river.
Flooding of the Yallourn open-cut mine presented a major challenge for engineers to divert the Morwell River. While a temporary dam and dewatering pumps were installed, a permanent solution for diverting the Morwell River was required. This could only be achieved with polyethylene pipe. Engineers decided on a single large pipeline that would take the entire flow of the Morwell River, reaching up to 800 megalitres per day. That required a 3.8 kilometre long, 1600 millimetre wide pipeline to be installed very quickly. PE100 was the material of choice because of the harsh installation conditions, ease of local manufacture, and its ability to be produced in the large diameters required. Due to the size of the pipe and the tight tolerances which had to be supplied, the market-leading melt strength of Alkadine HDF-145B from Quenos made it the only PE100 up to the challenge. The excellent dimensional tolerance reduced installation time as the pipe could be easily matched for welding. PE100 pipe was manufactured in Albury, New South Wales, and Welsh Pool in Western Australia, delivered to the Yallourn site where the 12-metre pipe lengths were welded into 120-metre pipe strings and dragged into place. Once the pipe strings were in place, they were welded together, completing the 3.8 kilometre pipeline diversion. The Morwell River was successfully diverted within 26 days, allowing the power station to get back to full capacity and thus securing Victoria's energy supply. Alkadine PE100, engineered to outperform.